Welcome to the lecture on strain gauging. In today's video, we shall discuss regarding slope area method of strain gauging. So what is this slope area method? This method is used to estimate peak flood discharge by flood marks at locations where no records in respect of stage or slope are available. So it is not possible to go for area velocity method and other methods. In that case, slope area method can be used effectively for measurement of discharge. But here the prerequisite is flood marks. So flood marks should be available. To use this method, two gauges with the same datum are established at some distance apart. The water surface slope is determined from two flood marks at these gauges relating to the same flood. So in case of this, flood marks are used for estimation of discharge. For that purpose, a stretch of a river or flow is or stream is selected, and then two gauges are established at certain distance apart. So here you can see, this is the stretch of the river, this L is the length of stretch of the river, and this is the bed slope of the river, and here you can see this datum, this is the datum, and this is the elevation of the upstream bed, this is the elevation of downstream bed. Y1 is the depth of water on upstream, Y2 is the depth of water on downstream, or this section 1 and this is section 2. So here you can say this is the water surface elevation. So A is the water surface elevation at section 1, B is the water surface elevation at section 2, and this is the velocity head V1 square by 2G at section 1 and V2 square by 2G at section 2, and it is the head loss due to eddies, and this is head loss due to friction. So this is the total head loss, this is the energy line. So this is the sketch which is helpful for determination of discharge. Now, this method is based on the principle of energy conservation. A stream reach is selected as shown in the figure, and then Bernoulli's equation is applied to the ends of the reach for section 1 and section 2. Let the length of the given reach of a stream be L and its bed slope S0. So here, this is the length of the strip and S0. It is the slope of the bed. Y1 and Y2 be water depths, and V1 and V2 be the velocities at the two ends. So Y1 is the depth of water on section 1, Y2 is depth of water at section 2, and V1 is the velocity at section 1, V2 is the velocity at section 2. Let A and B represent the water surface elevations at the two ends. So this A shows water surface elevation at A, B shows water surface elevation at section 2. Which are known and discharge flowing through the stream reach is to be computed. So all these parameters are known. Now we can apply the Bernoulli's equation. So applying Bernoulli's equation, we have between two sections Z1 plus Y1 plus V1 square by 2G equals to Z2 plus Y2 plus V2 square by 2G plus total head loss. So applying this between two sections, between these two sections, so here you can see Z1 plus Y1 plus V1 square by 2G equals to Z2 plus Y2 plus V2 square by 2G plus this head loss, total head loss. So applying Bernoulli's equation between these two sections, where HL is the head loss in the river reach, this HL is the head loss, and it is comprising of head loss due to friction and head loss due to eddies. So here Z plus Y is equals to H, water surface elevation above the datum. So in this figure Z plus H, so this Z1 plus H means Y, this is Z1 Y1 is the H1, Z2 Y2 is the H2, water surface elevation with reference to datum. So Z plus H, or you can say Z1 plus Y1, Z1 plus Y1 will give H1, and it is the water surface elevation in section 1. Similarly, Z2 plus Y2, it will give H2, it is nothing but water surface elevation at section number 2. Now, The flow is determined using Manning's equation. It is very simple. So in case of this, the flow in the river or in the stream can be determined by applying Manning's equation, which is given as Q equals to 1 by n r to the power 2 by 3 s to the power half multiplied by cross-sectional area A. So with this relationship, very easily we can determine the discharge into the river under this slope area method, where Q is discharge in cubic meter per second, A is the cross-sectional area of stream in square meter, R is the hydraulic mean radius in meter, S is water surface meter per meter, and N is Manning's roughness coefficient, mainly depends upon the nature of cross-section of the river. Now we shall discuss one numerical based on this slope area method. During the flood of a river, following data were collected, compute the flow discharge. River stage at two sides 1.70 km apart. So length of the stage is given 1.73 km apart, and the river stages are 380.38 meter and 400.20 meter respectively. Mean cross section of the channel is 335 square meter. Mean weighted perimeter of the area P is 98 meter. Condition of channel was a natural channel in fairly moderate condition. So this is the numerical. Now very first we shall construct the figure based on the given data. So here you can see this type of figure we can construct, so very easily we can find out the discharge. So here two sections are there, section A and section B, 1.73 km apart. Water surface elevation on section 1 is 400.20 meter, and section 2 is 380.38 meter. So you can develop this type of sketch. Now hydraulic mean radius R equals to A by P. So A is the cross-sectional area, P is the weighted perimeter. It is given in the numerical. A is 335 square meter and P is the 98 meter. With this we can get R equals to hydraulic mean radius equals to 3.418 meter. Now slope of the water surface, so this is required in this equation because Manning's equation is given as 1 by n r to the power this s to the power this and multiplied by a. A is given in the numerical, n we have to select based on the nature of the surface. Now r we have calculated, similarly we can calculate bed slope or slope of the water surface meter by meter. So 400.20 minus 380.38 divided by the distance, it is given in terms of kilometer, 1.73 multiplied by 1000, it will be converted into a meter. So meter per meter. So slope of the water surface is 0.01146 meter per meter. And now based on the channel condition, we have to select the Manning's roughness coefficient. So from the table, assuming 0.035 for moderate channel section having natural condition, this is the Manning's coefficient. Now substituting all these parameters in the Manning's equation, Q equals to 1 by n r to the power 2 by 3 s to the power half multiplied by a. So here n is 0.035, r is 3.418, s is 0.01146, and area is, cross-sectional area is 335 square meter. So with this we can get Q equals to 2325.92 square meter per second. So in this way, with the help of this slope area method, we can find out the discharge. So in case of this, sometimes short note is asked on this slope area method, or this type of simple numerical is asked. So it is very simple because Manning's formula is well known to you, which gives velocity multiplied by cross section, you will get the discharge, or you can say flow. So prepare short note on this slope area method or this numerical. So with this slope area method, and in turn you can say stream gauging topic is completed. With all respect, thank you.